Hello everybody and welcome to this update beginner's guide for Gigantic, covering the basics of the game and how it works. So here goes. When you first start in Gigantic, you'll begin on the airship. The airship is your base and your respawn point when you die. When you first spawn into the game, you'll see three glowing platforms. These lead off to the left, the middle, and the right side. These are what launch you into the actual battlefield themselves. Once you land in the battlefield, you come across summoning locations. These locations are indicated by beams of light shooting off into the sky. In these locations, you can summon monsters or creatures, as they are known. When you walk over a summoning platform, you'll be greeted by a menu on the left hand side of your screen. This menu allows you to summon creatures on these summoning locations and to collect power orb later in the game. I'll explain a bit more about power orb later on and a bit more about creatures as we go along. Now moving on to power. Power is a key resource for in Gigantic. You can gain power by collecting power orbs of summoning locations. These are worth 16 power each. Note, summons on summoning locations auto pick up power orbs. You can also gain 11 power from kills. These are the two main ways to gain power. I'll explain the third later down the line. What does power do in Gigantic? Once you reach 100 power, your guardian will go on a rampage and attack the other enemy guardian and put it in a down state. This lets your team attack the enemy guardian to destroy one of its lives. Each guardian is given 3 health bars. Once you kill all 3 health bars, you will win the game. Now, the other team can build up a shield before the enemy guardian is about to attack on its rampage. You can do this by attacking the guardian's power poles or getting kills from the enemy team when it's in its ready phase, just before it's about to rampage. This shield will block incoming damage from the enemy guardian as it's attacking on its rampage, or block player damage to protect the wound. There is a bit more to Gigantic than this though. Gigantic has two phases, pre-clash and clash. Treat both of these as separate game modes in the same game. Being pre-clash is at the start and middle of the game, and being clash is at the end of the game. When the game enters clash, your team and the enemy team can no longer summon. Also in clash, the third power gain option becomes available. This is stealing power directly from the enemy guardian by destroying its power gems. In clash, the map also becomes a lot smaller, so it becomes a lot more close quarters fighting and can flip the game from your side from winning to losing, so be careful. This is a basic guide for Gigantic for the stress test just gone. If you'd like to know more, check out my other guides. These talk about mat summoning meta. If you would like to see more or have any questions, you know what to do. And see you on the airship.